Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today just doing a little test drive here. It's finally getting some consistently good weather, so I am taking out the MGB. This is my first car. Not really going to go too much into the details of the car today. We can save that for another time. So I just have to throw some air in the tires, and we're going to take it out for a spin, just to do oil change and everything. And we'll see how it goes. I've got to do a little bit of rambling, and I've had a couple questions, so I'm going to answer those questions, and we'll just have a little bit of fun, take it for a quick spin. So now that we're on the move, what I wanted to talk about, I get a lot of questions about what's it like as a teacher during quarantine. Well, it's definitely been an adjustment, I can say that much. There's so many changes that it took a lot of getting used to, and the fact that I'm a technology education teacher, which for those of you who are, you know, layman's terms is a shop teacher, it's really tough to find things for your kids to do that are totally online based. On top of that, as a teacher, I get to know my students pretty well and develop relationships with them. That's really the, you know, first job as a teacher. And it can be tough, you know. I've got a couple of really talented seniors, and our school's already announced, since we're in New York State, that we won't be reopening. So I've got some students who I'm very likely not going to see again unless they, you know, come visit after, when they're in college or something and everything's back to normal. So that can be a little bit tough. What it really comes down to is getting the kids what they need and expecting the fact that, you know, it's in some areas, you might have five kids in a family and they only have one computer between them, even if the school lent them a computer, which luckily my school did, lent out Chromebooks and MiFis to just about every student and every family in the district. So, you know, we've done pretty well. They were, you know, my school was well ahead of the curve, did an awesome job. And, the problem that we run into is a lot of teachers panic. There's really two types of teachers, which I won't get into now, but those two types of teachers, the one type, they have a lot of trouble not recreating their entire classroom online, so the kids are, you know, super overloaded. And then there's the teachers like me who are doing, you know, what our administration asked, which is don't try and recreate your classroom, just boil it down to the essentials. So I give my students an hour, 2 hours of work a week, and I think that's pretty fair, considering how much they are likely doing for other courses, and it does a lot of good to them, There's not a whole lot that you can do if the kids either do it or don't. You just got to go with the flow. We try our best, and hopefully it all turns out for the best. So just one thing after another, taking it by your step. So it's all my teacher friends out there. Don't be intimidated if you feel like you're not getting anything done. It's not you. You're doing your best. You know, you're calling home, you're talking to your administrators, you're doing everything you have to. And it's all you can do. You know, don't beat yourself up over it. So, it's not a whole lot you can do. But I'm going to stop talking now. And we'll just let you guys listen to the soundtrack we got here. Love that popping on D-cell. This is a car that loves to be driven. And it's 17,000 original miles right now. I bought it when I was actually 15. I didn't even have my learner permit yet. Done a ton of work to it. It was my first car. I daily drove it for a couple years while I was in high school. Well, I should say senior year of high school. I wasn't in high school that long. I was not a super senior. But this car has treated me well. I haven't even washed this thing off yet. Let these kids go by. Figures three traffic lights in this town, and I always hit the red.